welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Xiaoting, and today I'm diving deep into my internship experience as a system software engineer at GovTech. For anyone aspiring to break into tech, especially in a government setting, or just curious about what a tech internship looks like, this video is for you. I'll be covering everything from the projects I worked on, the skills I gained, the challenges I faced, and the reflections on what I wish I had done better. So grab a coffee, sit back, and let's get into it. To start off, let me give you a quick overview of my internship. I interned at GovTech, Singapore's government technology agency, during the summer break of my year 2 as a computer science undergraduate at the National University of Singapore. My internship started as a full-time role during my 3-month summer break, and I was fortunate enough to continue part-time during my year 3 semester 1. In total, I spent 8 months working at GovTech, and it was a truly transformative experience. For those who may not know, GovTech is the main agency driving Singapore's digitalization efforts with a strong reputation for innovation and public sector tech solutions. GovTech has developed nationwide projects like Trace Together, which was used by millions of people during the COVID-19 pandemic to enhance contact tracing efforts. My main focus was developing applications for the Tammy robot, which is currently deployed at Changi Chapel and Museum. This isn't just any robot. It's a fully automated tour guide that interacts with visitors in 5 different languages. My job was to make sure it ran smoothly and could handle everything from controlling door sensors to playing audio guides. As the project progressed, I began to see the real-world impact of our work. Big media companies like CNN and the Straits Times visited the museum to cover the Tammy tour robot. They interviewed the public and published stories about this innovative guide, which brought a lot of attention to the project. Near the end of the project, there were even discussions about expanding our partnership, with places like Sentosa showing interest in deploying Tammy for tourism. As a developer, seeing how the project I was building had a real-world impact was incredibly rewarding. It was a proud moment to witness the positive reception and realize that our work was making a difference. Now, let's talk about the projects I worked on during my time at GovTech. My primary responsibility was developing 3 Flutter applications for Android and web, specifically for the Tammy robot. This involved working with a variety of tech stacks and tools like MQTT, network sockets, and cloud platforms to ensure everything from door sensors to audio playback worked seamlessly. One of the key tasks was integrating IoT sensors with Tammy's API. For example, I worked on controlling the doors and audio sensors within the museum, making sure the robot could give a complete, uninterrupted tour in multiple languages. This was my first time dealing with hardware in such a hands-on way, and it definitely pushed me out of my comfort zone. Another crucial part of my role was utilizing cloud services to monitor, alert, and log application activity. This was essential for managing the robot in real time and quickly responding to any issues that came up. I also worked on maintaining and developing in-house SDKs, which streamlined our development process. One of the most interesting features I got to work on was a live map for the admin tablet, allowing museum staff to track the robot's location in real time. This feature was particularly challenging, but incredibly rewarding once we got it up and running. Of course, no internship is without its challenges, and mine was no different. Being my first tech internship, I was thrown into a very intensive and wide-ranging environment that required a diverse set of skills. I had to quickly adapt to new technologies that I had little to no prior experience with. One of the biggest challenges was debugging across multiple systems, hardware, software, and network. For example, I spent a significant amount of time troubleshooting connectivity issues and ensuring the robot's sensors were always communicating properly with our cloud system. There were days where nothing seemed to work, but that's where I really learned the value of persistence and problem solving. It was overwhelming at times, managing such a broad range of technologies, from cloud computing to IoT, mobile development, APIs, robotics, and sensors. The learning curve was steep, and there were moments where I felt out of my depth, especially when dealing with unfamiliar tech stacks. But these challenges were also opportunities for me to grow and push myself beyond my limits. Now, let's talk about what I learned from this intense experience. As my first tech internship, the range of skills I needed to master was vast, and each new challenge brought with it a valuable learning opportunity. One of the most important things I gained was proficiency in a wide range of tech stacks, everything from cloud computing to IoT, mobile development, APIs, robotics, and sensors. Each of these areas required a different mindset and set of skills, and mastering them all was a daunting task. However, it also gave me a holistic view of how different technologies can work together to create something truly innovative. I learned how to integrate IoT sensors with cloud services, how to develop and deploy mobile applications using Flutter, and how to work with APIs to control hardware like Tammy Robot. This experience taught me the importance of understanding not just one aspect of a project, but the entire system architecture, which in turn enhanced my ability to troubleshoot and optimize performance. Another key learning point was the importance of adaptability. With so many new tools and technologies to learn, I had to quickly become an independent learner, relying heavily on online resources, documentation, and when I finally learned to do so, asking questions to accelerate my understanding. While I'm proud of what I accomplished during my internship, there are definitely a few things I wish I had done better. First and foremost, I didn't take full advantage of the mentorship opportunities available to me. I was too shy to ask questions because I didn't want to appear like I needed to be spoon-fed. I wanted to be seen as an independent learner, capable of figuring things out on my own. But the truth is, as an intern, there are bound to be more things you don't know than you know. Looking back, I realized how much easier and quicker it would have been to just ask questions and learn faster. Another reason I held back was fear. Fear of unfamiliar tech stacks and of being seen as incompetent. There were so many unfamiliar technologies thrown at me that I didn't even know what questions to ask. It wasn't until I got to year 3 and year 4 of my studies and learned modules on computer networks and cloud infrastructure that I fully understood the importance and relevance of the tech stacks I was using during this internship. Had I asked more questions and sought out more knowledge during my internship, I would have gained a much deeper understanding of the systems and technologies at play. Instead, I left some of the learning to the end of my school courses, only to realize I could have mastered this concept much earlier. There are four things I wish I would have done better. First, engage more with mentors. I should have scheduled more one-on-one sessions to discuss the broader system architecture and gain insights into advanced topics. Second, ask more questions. Don't let fear hold you back from asking questions, even if you think they might make you look inexperienced. It's better to ask and learn than to struggle alone. Third, overcome fear of unfamiliar tech. It's okay to feel overwhelmed by unfamiliar tech stacks, but instead of avoiding them, dive in and ask the questions that will help you understand them. This will build your confidence and speed up your learning process. Finally, building stronger connections. I didn't focus enough on networking and building relationships within the team. This is so important not just for career growth, but also for creating a supportive work environment. So, my advice to anyone in a similar position, ask a lot of questions. Be curious and make sure you really understand the system, architecture, and design. It helps you gain more knowledge about the project, speeds up your learning, boosts your confidence, and ensure you have greater takeaways from the internships. As I wrap up, I want to share a few final pieces of advice for anyone about to start a tech internship or even just considering one. Be proactive, take initiative, seek out learning opportunities, and don't wait for tasks to come to you. The more proactive you are, the more you'll learn. Ask questions. Never be afraid to ask questions. It's better to ask and learn than to stay silent and miss out on valuable knowledge. Network and build relationships. Make an effort to connect with your colleagues. These relationships can provide mentorship, career opportunities, and lasting friendships. Internships are about learning and growing, so don't be too hard on yourself if things don't go perfectly. Take every experience as a lesson and keep pushing forward. Hey guys! Thank you so much for watching till the end. I really appreciate your support. As a token of my appreciation, I want to give away some free resources that I think could be really helpful to you. First, I've put together a summary note of everything we cover in this video. It's a quick, easy to read PDF that highlights all the key points from my GovTech internship experience, what I learned, the challenges I faced, my regrets, and some advice if you're looking to get into tech. But that's not all. I understand that breaking into the tech industry can be really intimidating, especially at the start. That's why I want to help you out. At the end of September 2024, I'm hosting a free livestream session where I'll be answering your questions about breaking into tech. We'll cover important topics like job applications, interview tips, networking, and anything else you're curious about. This is your chance to get some personalized advice directly from me, and it's completely free, no hidden cost. Now, it does take a lot of time and effort to prepare these resources and put myself out there to help, so this will probably be my first and last time doing this, especially since I just started my full-time software engineering role after graduation, and I'll only get busier from here. So, if you're facing challenges or have questions about your tech career, grab this opportunity and join the livestream. All you have to do is click the link below, submit your email, and you'll get instant access to the summary note and all the details for the livestream. Thanks again for watching, and I can't wait to see you at the livestream. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!